Dynamite Headdy for the Game Gear. Man, I don't know what I think about Dynamite Headdy. On the Sega Genesis, came out in 1994, developed by Treasure, highly regarded by a lot of people. It's definitely a really good looking game on the Sega Genesis, like most of the Treasure games. But also, like most of the Treasure games, it's kind of like a never-ending boss run. It's boss fight after boss fight. And short levels, not really my cup of tea. I would have rather had longer levels, more platforming, and, you know, yeah, a boss fight at the end of, you know, each level. I don't know. It's an alright game. It's kind of hard. Is actually one of those rare instances where the game was developed in Japan, released in Japan first, and when they brought it over to North America, they actually made it harder. Which a lot of times it's the other way around. When a game comes from Japan to North America, they make it easier. But there are a few exceptions where it's the other way around, and this is one of those games. But you know what? To think that the Japanese version is easier, maybe I should try that one out. But again, this is one of those games that they actually made it harder over here. I think because they thought people would rent it and beat it in one rental and then not buy the game. So they wanted to make the game harder. You'd rent it, maybe you wouldn't be able to beat it in the time that you rented it, and then you would be more likely to buy it. I guess that's the story. Anyways, it's a great looking game, and you know what? It's a pretty amazing port to the 8-bit Game Gear. No doubt about it. The game looks great, and it runs great. Controls are nice and responsive. Technically, it's pretty impressive. But again, do I like the game? it's a lot of boss fights. I found it kind of difficult this playthrough, although I've actually gotten further than this on the Game Gear. Playing it on a real Game Gear, I've actually gotten further than I was able to get here recording it in emulation. And I don't even think I'm blaming it on emulation this time, because this game runs perfectly smooth in emulation. I think it was just I was having an off day, and I couldn't get past this one boss. It didn't really seem that hard looking at it. But again, maybe it was just an off day. I have gotten further in this game than I could get this time. So I'm honestly not sure if this game is considered to be difficult. If it's considered to be too difficult, I don't think so. Definitely a difficult game. It's definitely got some... especially, you know what, on the Game Gear, for how small your screen is, you obviously don't have... It's cropped, right? Like, your resolution is lower, and so everything's cropped, and you're going to have less enemies on the screen. Makes for a simpler game in a way, which you would think would make it easier, but doesn't seem to. You know, the Genesis version, I can get further, what feels like a lot further... in the Genesis version than what I was able to get here again. So, I don't know. It seems like it should be a simpler game. But I wasn't able to get really that far. So, again, not really sure what I think about this game. Great looking game. Runs really well. If you really like Dynamite Headdy on the Genesis, and you like the fact that it's really short levels and a lot of boss fights, then you're going to like this game for sure. It's not a bad port. It's actually a good port. I got mixed feelings about Dynamite Headdy to begin with, even on the Genesis. So let me know what you think. If you've played this game, how difficult do you consider this game to be? And it's, again, if you like Dynamite Headdy, it's definitely worth... checking out the Game Gear version if you're a fan of the Game Gear. It is a good port. Just not sure if it's my cup of tea.